I didn't even know this place existed. I'm gonna have my birthday party here. Mark has invited me to this incredible vintage warehouse that has all kinds of old Mac computers. Specifically the 1984 Mac, which is something that has a very special place in my heart.
Yeah, it's good.
It's so great.
They don't make them like they used to.
Do you want to open it up? So there are a few screws here. Should we go for it?
I think we should take it apart.
All right, final screw.
Okay.
But let's lift this off. Do not touch the CRT coil because you might get shocked.
Okay, inside is the CRT monitor goes kind of far into the body of it.
Don't touch
it. Okay, I'm not gonna touch the CRT coil.
Mm-mm.
I'll hold the bottom down.
Okay, ready?
Yeah, yeah. Moment of truth.
Oh, man, look at this.
That is the inside of a 1984 Mac. That's the coil. Don't touch the CRT. There are two different boards. There's, to me, unrecognizable, mostly power components. And then there's also a board back here at the bottom, which has a lot more soldering. That's the floppy drive.
The system disk is the floppy disk. So that basically loads it into the RAM. And then as soon as you take that disk out, it's gone. You're basically loading things as it goes.
And it would be a combination of reading from the memory that it has preloaded things into and that floppy disk.
This only had 128K of RAM.
What, now it's 1,000 times smaller?
One front-facing selfie on the iPhone, you couldn't even fit it on here. Like, that's insane. Steve Jobs had created this as a work of art. So in most art, people sign them. So inside of here are autographs of all of the people that worked on this team.
Oh, that's
cool. So you can see them
right
there.
And they're subtle. All these little inscriptions, that's actually a nice little touch, signing your work. I'm glad we learned all this today. Thank you so much for helping me take apart this Mac and for giving me the breakdown.
Thank you so much. This was seriously amazing. Wow.